Hi everybody, it's Hanna with Fullstory here with another session of Fullstory LinkedIn Live. I'm so excited to be here with Tommy Noonan, a product manager here at Fullstory.
Yeah, thanks Hanna, happy to be here.
Thanks for joining us this Friday afternoon. We're coming at you from our Fullstory headquarters here in Atlanta, Georgia. And today we're going to be talking about product metrics. So just a reminder, this is a live session, so please feel free to leave any comments below. If you have questions, we'll answer those later on in this session. Also, we're going to be talking about metrics today, and if this is a topic that you're really excited about, we're having a webinar actually later on in June with Amplitude. We'll be talking about North Star metrics and how do you create North Star metrics, what does that mean for your business. So there should be a link in the comments if you're interested in joining that webinar. Please do sign up. So Tommy, just to kick us off, tell us a little bit about yourself. How did you end up at Fullstory?
Yeah, for sure. So I actually started my career at Accenture as a systems integration consultant. So I did a lot of things like building custom solutions for more larger enterprise clients. And then I actually came to Fullstory from business school. So I interned at Google as a product management intern on their mobile search team right before switching to here.
Cool. How did you fall into product management?
Yeah, that is a great question. I feel like when I got to grad school, I had never heard of a product manager before, but I knew I really wanted to work with data to make decisions, be in front of customers, and affect the development or the strategy of the product. And so everybody was like, that really sounds like a B2B product manager. And I was like, yes, that's what I want to do. That's what I want to get into.
That's awesome. So you're obviously very interested in data and how we can make better decisions using data. How do you think about product metrics?
Yeah, for sure. To me, product metrics are all about decision making. They should be able to enable your organization to make better decisions faster. And I kind of think about that along two axes. First is strategically. It's, you know, are you tracking the right metrics? I think about that as I want my metrics to tell me, are customers being able to, I guess, complete the use cases that they're coming to our product to, you know, to do? Operationally, that's all about, like, are the metrics easy for everyone to interpret, to read? Like, is everybody on the same page? Do they know where to find them? But more of, like, actually, like, once you have the metrics, what do you do with them?
Yeah, because you have to do something with that data. Otherwise, it's not operationalized.
I hope people do stuff with it, at least.
Yeah. So what's the difference between a product metric and a KPI?
Yeah, I actually think of these as fairly similar. Mm-hmm. At least I use the two terms pretty interchangeably.
Yeah. And do you think that PMs are the best person to be the owner of product metrics?
I actually do think PM should be the owner, but it needs to be a collaborative process. And what I mean by that is I'm definitely a firm believer that if everybody owns something, no one owns something, kind of a tragedy of the commons type thing. But like I said, it needs to be collaborative. There are some things that maybe like an engineer or a designer might understand a little bit better than a product manager. Product managers should probably work with their customer success teams and their support teams to get a better understanding of like what their actual customers are saying when they start to develop metrics that they're going to actually make decisions off of.
That makes sense. And we talked last week about cross-functional collaboration, and it seems like that's just a reoccurring theme that I hear when I talk with PMs, both here at Fullstory and at other companies, is no matter your role as a PM, whether you're focused on data or launching new features or whatever, it's really you're connecting to other people across the business to understand how do we move forward.
Yeah, and that's a great point. Like, product metrics are important because they help create that alignment between all these different organizations at your company. You know, without product metrics, it's hard for everybody to speak on the same page. It's hard for people to prioritize things if everybody is kind of focused on different metrics or different ways to think about things. You know, I feel like the mental resources that we all have are kind of the scarcest resource that we have at the, you know, companies like this. And so being able to prioritize things quickly and effectively is super important.
Yeah. What makes a good product metric versus a bad one? Is there a bad one?
I think there are probably certainly bad ones, but it also depends on, you know, what you're trying to track.
Sure.
So churn to me is actually an example of potentially a great product metric. Like, what better way for someone to tell you that they're not getting use out of their product for them to actually stop using you and churn? But it can also be a bad product metric because if I'm looking at churn, it's kind of too late. Yeah. I would like to know that customers or users aren't completing their use cases, you know, well before they actually make the decision to quit.
Yeah, so you need some of those leading indicators.
Exactly.
Yeah, definitely. So we're a quick growing company. Let's talk a little bit about growth. How do you think product metrics change throughout growth?
Yeah. Product metrics definitely can and should change as the company grows. And I definitely want to reiterate that it all goes back to the customer and how your product is evolving to meet your customer's needs. I think an example of that would be like at Fullstory, we probably originally found product market fit more in like the SaaS support use cases. And so how did we best serve those customers? They were coming into Fullstory every day to analyze different customer trends, watch sessions of people encountering bugs, etc. Mm-hmm. So that was something that we said daily active users is very important for us at that time. As our product has evolved a little bit and as we start tackling new use cases such as conversion rate optimization, product manager use cases, we kind of decided that daily active user isn't a necessity for these users. So maybe weekly active is the right way to start thinking about this. There's definitely never going to be like a light that comes on that says it's time to change your product metrics. Nothing is black and white. But I think like the kind of perpetual, constantly reevaluating who my customers are, how are they most getting value out of my product, is the best way to really decide what metrics should I be tracking.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. For those of you who are joining us, I'm talking with Tommy Noonan. He's a product manager here at Fullstory. We're talking about metrics. If you have any thoughts on product metrics, either ones that you think are really great or other ideas about how you measure engagement with your app, please feel free to post those in the comments below. So we talked a little bit about how as your company evolves, your customer base usually evolves, your market fit evolves, and your metrics need to evolve as well. So how do you keep your metrics fresh?
Yeah, for sure. I definitely recommend, it's kind of like what customer interactions. Mm-hmm. Like you need to be very in tune with like what your customers are doing and like what are the most important features and what are the core problems they're trying to solve.
Yeah.
That's certainly key. And you know, we've actually developed a North Star metric, which I know we're having our webinar on in a couple weeks.
Yeah.
It's kind of a way for us to say, there's a lot of different metrics out there. There's probably a lot of different use cases people are trying to do, but this is kind of the thing that we hold, I guess, above the rest of them. And if, an example of that at Fullstory is we actually track weekly active explorers, mm-hmm. so users that come into our app once a week and use search or segment as kind of like our metric that, you know, as of right now, we're tracking as like the core metric for Fullstory product team.
Yeah, I think it's really clarifying to have a North Star metric because then you're able to say, okay, we have all of this data, we have all these metrics, and this is the one that we really care about tracking towards, the one we really want to prioritize.
Definitely. And that goes all back into the alignment of different teams. But it also kind of speaks to, you know, what happens when metrics go up or down. Like, mm-hmm. how do we interpret the change that we're seeing? In my opinion, interpreting and reading that change is probably more important than the metrics themselves.
Yeah.
And so when you have a North Star metric and you actually take the time to like socialize it and weave it throughout the fabric of your product team, it's really can be enlightening in terms of like, oh, a metric that we have is going down or up, but it doesn't change our North Star metric. Mm-hmm. You know, that might be something that we prioritize. This is not the most burning thing on my plate right now. I can look at that at the end of the week. It's not a drop everything that I'm doing right now.
Yeah, that's a good rubric. When you think about metrics and socializing them, how do you go about doing that?
Yeah, for sure. Data is certainly the great equalizer to me, and I think of myself as a data-driven person, so I probably rely on that, maybe even more than I should, but it always is really helpful when you're going to people that you know have to be bought in on a North Star metric, whether it's product marketers, engineering managers, what have you, to say, you know, there's a reason why I'm led to this specific metric. Maybe it's something that reflects what you think of as like the core strength of your product. Maybe it's something that you think of as, you know, the users that use this metric tell us that they're getting the most value out of our product. So being able to kind of back up why you're choosing one thing or another is, to me, extremely important when it comes to like actually convincing everybody to come around it.
Yeah, definitely. You talked a little bit about responding when your metric either goes down or up. And how do you know when you should respond versus, oh, this is just normal fluctuations based on things that are happening?
Yeah, so this is definitely like a million-dollar question, and I'm sure it keeps a lot of people up, myself included, mm-hmm. at night. One of the ways I tackle that is with the North Star metric. It at least gives me a little bit of clarity in terms of, okay, this is going down. It's important, but it's not necessarily the most burning thing mm-hmm. on my plate. But there's also, we have the idea of like KPI or metrics trees. And those are probably best represented by like, how are our metrics related to each other? Or like, how does mm-hmm. one thing affect another?
Yeah.
Taking our weekly active explorer, for instance, I think of it as a weekly active explorer is a combination of how many monthly active users we have, what percentage of those monthly active users are coming into our app on a weekly basis, and then lastly, what percentage of those weekly active users are actually exploring. So that way, when I see my North Star metric go up and down, I can kind of immediately pinpoint, oh, monthly active users is down, it's Christmas time. But mm-hmm. the people who are actually here, they're searching, they're coming into the app frequently. That's something that I say, okay, no worries. Like that.
Yeah.
So it just gives you like a head start and like a little bit of clarity in terms of what to look for.
Yeah, it seems like you still have to contextualize the data elsewhere though, understanding like what other factors might be at play.
Yeah, absolutely. And kind of thinking about this in the positive light of mm-hmm. what happens when your North Star metric goes up,
yeah.
you know, this is something that we look at really closely when it comes to things like feature launches
mm-hmm.
or, you know, big drastic changes in the product. An example for this for Fullstory is a few months ago, we launched a feature called Custom Events, and we noticed that our customers that were using the feature were actually performing better on the North Star metric than our customers who weren't.
Hmm.
So that in and of itself was like, great. Like we released something that we wanted to change our North Star metric, and it did. But what was really enlightening for us was actually looking at the KPI tree and figuring out why the weekly active explorer numbers were going up. And that was when we found, you know, super quickly, because we already have a framework for analyzing these things. Oh, these were actually never before seen users that were coming into our customers' apps mm-hmm. and using Fullstory now because they wanted to use this new functionality. So that was something that was like, I guess, a great product metric win for us in
yeah.
being able to kind of predict what would happen and then actually see it happen in our metrics.
Yeah, I love that. If anyone who's viewing has any product metric wins you'd like to share, you can do that below in the comments. I'm curious, if someone is watching this and they're wanting to get started, maybe creating a North Star metric or becoming more data-driven, what advice do you have for them?
Yeah, that's a great question. Let me think about where to begin. For me, I think it's, when I think about when I first came to Fullstory, it was like making sure that we had the data needed to analyze the mm-hmm. things I wanted to analyze or start to like, you know, start to string all these things together, eventually bubbling up into a North Star metric.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of times at early stage companies, you might not necessarily have like an entire BI or an analytics team that's sole focus is to work on an analytics stack that people can query and draw inferences from.
Mm-hmm.
So that was something that was, you know, very, very big for me, I would say, is understanding what data you have and then how to get the most value out of it. Because even though getting the data is important, I think you'll find pretty quickly that there's a plethora of things you can analyze. So it's really about asking the right questions and figuring out what you want to track. And I think that all goes back to the customer, trying to understand who are the people that you're trying to serve and what do I need to know to best serve them.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. So you sort of start with that perspective of understanding your customer and then using that to say, okay, what are the questions that I care about and then how can I answer those questions with data?
Yes, exactly.
Okay, cool. That makes a lot of sense. So you mentioned tech stack. What is in your tech stack that you love for understanding your users and metrics?
Yeah, for sure. So I don't think this is going to surprise anyone, but I am a very big Fullstory user, both the actual UI, and I'm a heavy power user of our data export feature, which is kind of like the raw data underlying mm-hmm. everything that you might analyze in the app. I also have a SQL background from Accenture, so I love using BigQuery.
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of the, I guess, analytics warehouse that we use to take things from, you know, not just product engagement data, but things like Salesforce, customer support tickets, like customer segmentation data, kind of everything I can meld together in that type of environment. And then we also have Looker that sits on top of that that's been super helpful. Honestly, not as much from the data visualization side, but more of just like how is our business logic to convert all of this disparate data into actual insights. Mm-hmm. Looker kind of houses that for us.
Yeah, that's awesome. I think from my perspective, I know that I've gotten to work with you on some data projects and saying, like, when we launch new features, how are people engaging with this? What's happening? But it's been really exciting to see you roll out North Star metrics here at Fullstory, and I think it's created a lot of clarity around what are people doing in our app and what do we want to truly be tracking towards. So I think as an observer of that, I can recognize the value of using data to make decisions.
Yeah, well, that's definitely great to hear. And you know, the North Star metric has definitely been super enlightening for me. Like, I almost saw it as like product management tech debt, as opposed to being kind of reactionary every single time like we heard of something or something was going on. We now are at least kind of like monitoring what we feel is the right thing and like responding appropriately.
Yeah, definitely. That's awesome. So we're going to turn to the audience now. If you have any questions, please feel free to drop them in the comment section. We did have a comment. I think this is great. It said, the age-old question, no one grew up wanting to be a product manager, which that certainly seemed to be your experience.
Yeah, I would definitely say so.
Do you have any advice for people who maybe are considering a career in product management?
Yeah, for sure. You know, I definitely took one route to product management. I went to consulting and then business school and transferred in here. But I almost think that one of the better ways to do it is just to go ahead and, you know, actually get into companies that have product management positions, even if you're not going to be a product manager, and, you know, just show them that, you know, you are, I guess, like, you know, the right person for it. There's definitely no right way to get into the field.
Yeah, definitely. So we talked a little bit about someone who's just starting off measuring engagement or product metrics. What metrics would you specifically suggest a small team start off with?
Yeah, that's a great question.
Is it daily active users, monthly active users? It just depends, maybe.
Yeah, I definitely recommend that those are probably the core three I would start with: monthly, weekly, and daily. Mm-hmm. And then from there, it's like knowing what type of business you are. Are you like transactional based, that maybe people just come to create a transaction and aren't really coming like on a daily basis to complete tasks?
Sure.
That might have something different. You might be tracking transactions instead of just users that are coming.
Yeah, definitely. And what do you think the challenge is for people who are trying to create product metrics? Are there specific challenges you've faced that others might be facing?
You know, getting everybody to align on metrics is, you know, tough.
Yeah.
And you're not going to get alignment unless you prove that you're willing to listen to everyone who, you know, has something to say about it. And, you know, listening to people from different perspectives, I think, is super important. I think data is helpful, and it can help build conviction in yourself before you, you know, want to present an idea out there that you know is probably going to get poked and prodded from every single way. But, you know, listening to people, building that trust, and showing them kind of your thought process for building up to a North Star metric was super helpful for me.
Yeah, definitely. That makes a lot of sense. Great. Well, thank you so much for being here with us today. I really appreciate your time and insights.
Yeah, absolutely. This was fun.
Yeah, awesome. So, and thank you for watching. If you've been interested in product metrics, you want to learn more, we're having a webinar with Amplitude at the end of June, so please join us for that. You'll be talking about North Star metrics.
Yep.
And we'll be talking with a PM from Amplitude about North Star metrics too. If you enjoyed this content, please follow our LinkedIn page. We'll be back here next week with another LinkedIn Live. Thanks, everybody.